The first two ayat, before I get to the ayat, I want to share just a general idea so you understand what it's getting at. We said before, expanding the chest means to put your mind at ease, to make you comfortable with something. There's a person who is a Muslim, and they know that Allah commands, this is haram, and this is mandatory, and this is mandatory. They do it. They know it's from Islam, but they don't understand it. They don't find it logical. They accept it, they do it, but they don't really, their mind is not totally satisfied with that commandment. Even though they're obeying, their chest is not at rest. There's some sort of unease with the commandments. Now you have this at two levels. You have a person who's actually not comfortable with the commandments because they don't see the logic in it. First of all, we shouldn't be trying to make logic out of the commandments of Allah, even though they're full of wisdom. We may or may not ever discover that wisdom. The fact that it's from Allah should be enough for a believer. But generally though, not speaking idealistically, generally speaking, among those who believe, there is a tendency to say, I wonder why Allah, you know, wants me to do this. Why does He want me to, why is it 2.5%? What about this inheritance law? How come they get this percent, that they get that percent, they get this fraction? I don't get it. What's the point of that? What's this, what's so haram about riba? And then other things that are very close to riba, which are bay', are, you know, halal. I don't understand the difference between them. So this person is sort of at unrest. Then compared to that is a person who is completely at ease with Allah's commands. They're completely at ease. They understand, either they see the wisdom in it, they can appreciate the wisdom in it, or even if they don't appreciate the wisdom in it, the fact that it's from Allah, they are thoroughly, deeply convinced whatever Allah gives me is better for me. And I'm very, very happy that I'm getting this treatment from Allah. They treat the ahkam of Allah kind of like medicine. Even if it tastes bad, I know for sure it's good for me, and I'm glad I'm receiving the medication. I'm really happy to be getting the medication. So that's how they treat it. So this is one kind of, you know, inshirah as-sadr for the Muslim. And these are two ayat in Quran that basically talk about the same exact concept. One of them, فَمَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَهْدِيَهُ يَشْرَحْ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ. Then whoever Allah intends to, that he should guide him, he expands his chest for Islam. Now Allah did not say expands his chest for Iman. He said expands his chest for Islam. What's the difference between Iman and Islam? Iman is faith. Allah is one, there's a hereafter, Muhammad is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is Iman. What is Islam? It is submission, it's obedience. Right? So where does the discomfort come in the obedience? And Allah says whoever Allah truly wants to guide, then He puts in them this relaxation in submitting before Allah. In Islam. Allah expands their chest for Islam. That's one place. Then another place, أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ. Then as for the one who Allah expanded his chest for Islam, for submission, Allah made him comfortable with submitting before Allah, فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّن رَبِّهِ. Then it's like he is from a light. He has a light that he's walking on, given to him by his master. In other words, what that means is, you know, I'm doing it, I'm not so sure why I'm doing it. I don't even see the point, I'll just do it anyway. I won't question it too much, but I'm not comfortable with it internally. As opposed to this, the one whose chest has been opened, he obeys Allah, and he believes deep in his heart that this is beneficial for me. It's like comparing two people, one is walking in the dark, and the other one has been given a light that he can walk with. SubhanAllah. So this is one kind of opening of the chest. Musa alayhi salam has a stutter. And he has a very strong temper. So when he goes before Fir'aun and he speaks and he hears the most ridiculous, obnoxious lies and falsehood and insults against the truth, he will be offended. When he gets offended, he describes this to Allah Azza wa Jal. He says, وَيَضِيقُ صَدْرِي إِنِّي أَخَافُ أَن يُكَذِّبُونَ وَيَضِيقُ صَدْرِي وَلَا يَنْطَلِقُ لِسَانِي. He says, my chest becomes tight and then my tongue doesn't move. What did he complain about? His chest becoming tight. In other words, his chest becoming tight has to do with his mission. When he goes on the mission of delivering Allah's message, he will hear things that will make him cringe. And at that point, his chest will become tight. And when your chest becomes tight and you're uncomfortable, you're not able to do your job as best you can. Especially with Musa alayhi salam, he'll start stuttering, right? So he asks Allah Azza wa Jal, رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي. The same, on the one hand, he said, my chest will become tight. On the other hand, he asked Allah, oh Allah, expand my chest for me. Musa alayhi salam had to ask for his chest to be expanded. Isn't that true?